Acoustic Cafe, featuring artists in the contemporary folk and acoustic music scene, and with your host, Brad Paul. Tonight, our guest is Louis Collins, featured in performance live at the 3rd Annual Falcon Ridge Folk Festival in Hillsdale, New York.
Between us, one holy instant of grace. I leave behind my misperceptions, and so begins the dance of love. So quick I've been to see my failings in others, my anger rising, growing into them, yet now see I've stood in my own way. What fear is this in me that blocks expression of myself? Why do I deny myself what truly brings me joy? An easel stands before me on which I draw my life. The colors and the shapes and shades are none but mine to choose. Choose to open wide my hands there to receive your love, and from my center circling fill the light is passed along. So open I receive, I give, I know it is the same, and I am one and still remembering as when dawn. Thank you.
We'll return with a conversation with Louis Collins at the Falcon Ridge Folk Festival on the Acoustic Cafe right after this.
You never know what to expect from adopted children. This one became president. And this one went far in education. And this adopted kid dove into world fame. Adopted children are just like other kids. They're kids with great expectations.
You better think, think, think about that drink before you die. Think, 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 it takes good judgment to stay alive. Think, please.
Help conserve our forests. To find out what you can do, write to Forests, National Wildlife Federation, Washington, D.C., 20036.
Hi, and welcome to the Acoustic Cafe. This show is part of a special series that is brought to you from the Falcon Ridge Folk Festival in Hillsdale, New York, where one of the featured performers is Louis Collins. Hi, Louis.
Hi, Brad.
How are you doing?
Just fine.
Well, it's really fine to see you back out on the performing circuit again.
Thanks.
It's been a long time. I think probably the last time I saw you was maybe 83 or 82 at Passim. Is that
That's a long
is that
time,
about right?
though. Yeah, probably.
When
yeah.
did I know you had your last album was In the Light. It was on Green Linnet Records.
There's a Light.
There
yeah.
is a Light, rather.
Yeah.
And was that around 83 that came out, 84?
That was 84, 85. Mm-hmm. That was around 85 that came out. Same time my second child was born.
Yeah. yeah. Was there similarities between giving birth to the record and your child?
No, the children birth much easier than the records do.
I thought you were going to say it was the other way around.
No, I birth easy, actually.
Yeah. But you have a hard time getting
records through the
studio process and getting performers.
Yeah, it seems to take a long time for me. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, the last record was produced by one of the Cunninghams. Is it
Johnny?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
How was that working with... With John, he's done a lot in the last few years, hasn't he?
He's wonderful, yeah. He's just a real pleasure to work with. Mm-hmm. It's really fun, and he's just really, really talented.
Yeah.
So it was fun. When I first talked to him on the phone, I had sent him a tape, and we'd been talking about my process in recording, and he said, well, you know, I think that when you get in the studio, you'll find that less is more. And I said, you're hired.
Words that you wanted to hear.
Yeah, yeah. And he was wonderful at just hearing and listening for what was really appropriate and how to fit it in right and how to make it balanced and full without being too much.
Mm-hmm.
And excellent ear for
that. It wasn't too long after that released that album that you stopped performing, though.
Yeah, it wasn't too long.
So what happened? Did you just have enough of the road life and needed to be with your kids, or was it more than that?
It was a lot more than that,
uh-huh.
Yeah. And as I look back on it, I think that the reason behind my quitting was really that I didn't know anymore why I was doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like I was doing it for the wrong reasons, and that maybe good things were happening, but without it being focused and without me knowing why I was doing it.
Mm-hmm. What would some of the wrong reasons be? Just a lack of... really knowing.
Because I'd always done that.
Uh-huh.
No, I still remember when I graduated from college, my father saying, well, what are you going to do now that you're graduating? And I said, sing. And he said, well, don't you want to get a regular job? And I said, no. And it was just that was what I wanted to do. And I always knew that was what I wanted to do. And I think it just kind of went into that's what I did. That's what I did well. And I just kept doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And it was good, and I loved playing most of the time, but I felt like I'd kind of got lost somewhere along there. Maybe that's what a midlife crisis is, I don't know.
Well, you know, a lot of your songs, as I was thinking, watching you perform a little bit earlier, that obviously we're seeing throughout this part of the show, songs like The Coming of the Snow or The Endless Mile are very introspective songs. I mean, I can almost see you in your house in Connecticut, you know, with the snow falling and being a very self or centered, you know, and sort of to yourself and writing these songs.
That's how I write, really.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a very quiet, centered place that I come from when I do write well, anyway. I write sometimes from other places, but I feel like when I write well, it's when I'm very centered and connected. And that's kind of involved in why I had to stop, too. I'm not sure exactly why, but I needed to be more connected.
Mm-hmm.
And
now, at some point, obviously, you made the decision that you were going to get back out there. It's about a year and a half ago.
Yeah, about that.
I started seeing your name show up on concert calendars and flyers.
Somebody asked me to do a concert, and I said, no, I won't do this. And I ended up saying, all right, I'll just do this one and see how it is, and I loved it. And then through this whole thing, there was a whole process of me learning more about myself, about who I am, and a lot of writing going on, even while I was off stage.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of real changes happening in me. And I got to the point where I felt like it was real important for me to be able to share the writing and to share who I am and what I've been going through, and to be with people again in a way that I wasn't being with people at that time.
Mm-hmm. I'm feeling you've reached the point where you could really get back connected with the audience when you're performing.
Yeah, I felt like to do the growth that I needed to do, I couldn't be on stage.
Mm-hmm.
I had to be separate from it for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And because while I kept doing what I had been doing, I kept in the old patterns.
Mm-hmm.
And then in order to change some of those patterns, I just really needed to stop.
Now, some of the kids that you've had over the last few years, are they going to be playing more of a role in your songwriting and your performing, do you think?
I don't know, but they're playing more of a role in my music right now. It's
exciting.
We're taking Suzuki violin lessons together, the two older kids and me, and that's fun. It feels like there's a whole new energy in my house right now toward music,
and you know, the children participating in it and me participating in music with them. It's really fun.
Yeah.
More than just me singing with them.
Yeah.
You know, taking it really a step beyond that. And I'm excited about that.
Could be a family band in the offing, right?
I don't know about that.
No. Well, thanks for taking a few minutes to spend with us, and we really look forward to seeing the rest of your performance.
Thanks.
And look forward to seeing you on the road in the future.
Thanks, Brad.
We'll return with more music from Louis Collins on the Acoustic Cafe right after this.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
If you're not recycling, you're throwing it all away.
Hi, this is Cliff Robertson, inviting you to become a host family for the American Intercultural Student Exchange. For information, call 1-800-SIBLING. Thanks.
Recorded live in concert, this is Louis Collins at the Falcon Ridge Folk Festival.
Moon dancer, I'll be a moon dancer, glide as I waltz on my clumsy old feet. Once I was conscious of every false step, now I dance in the moonlight with no one to see. I have a friend who was awkward and shy. He was not like the others, but he didn't know why. When all that he wanted was just to be cool, he tried playing the hero, he'd just play the fool. Moon dancer, now he's a moon dancer, glides as he waltzes on clumsy old feet. Once he was conscious of every false step, now he dances in moonlight with no one to see. My little girl is so lovely and free, at ease with her body, she's nothing like me. No one has taught her to be someone else, at this tender age she takes joy in herself. Moon dancer, she is a moon dancer, glides as she waltzes on graceful young feet. She's never been conscious nor watched every step, so she dances in moonlight with no one to see. My little son is the joy of my days, a gift come unto me to lighten my way. Though he cannot walk, he has led me to you, for though body is matter, the spirit is truth. Moon dancer, he is a moon dancer, glides as he waltzes on straight and strong feet. Knowing no limits, his body is set free to dance in the moonlight with no one to see. Moon dancer, let us be moon dancers, glide as we waltz on our graceful old feet. Accepting no limits, we set ourselves free to dance in the moonlight with no one to see. Let us dance in the moonlight with no one to see.
Called Holy Child that I wrote to the child within each of us.
Walking tenderly, smoothing
world breaks free to dance for joy. Thank you. Would you like to sing one more song with me? Oh, good. This this song is one of my series of love songs. I have a theory about love songs, and I know that we're all now getting much more conscious about the earth and doing things, recycling things and reusing things and just really making, living in harmony with the environment. And I think that we really ought to be conscious of the same thing with songs, you know, and reuse them and recycle them. And so I have a theory about love songs, because you can get into a lot of trouble with love songs with this environmentalist approach. So there's one thing that you have to keep in mind when you're writing a love song. If you want it to be recyclable, there is one thing that you must remember each time, and that is, do not write the person's name in the song. Never, never. Especially in the case of, no, never mind. This, I won't tell you my deepest, darkest secrets. This this song I wrote right after I met my husband. No, what the hell, I will tell you my deepest, darkest secrets. I wrote it right after I met my husband. I wrote it for someone else. But it's his, it's really his. And so I'm gonna sing this for Rod. He's around here somewhere, he and my three kids, my little moon dancers, Silva and Timothy and Magdalene, they're all here. They were blowing bubbles. We spent a little while before I was on stage, before we came over to hear Chris, blowing bubbles over at the children's tent. It's really turning into a great day here, isn't it? It's nice to see the sun out there. Okay, so if you'll sing this one last song with me, I'd really appreciate it, and welcome you to enjoy the rest of the day out here. I'm gonna come out and sit with you when I'm finished up here. Enjoy the sunlight. This is called Wildflower Song.
Too many times I've fallen for a bold, flirtatious smile. My emotions had a way of breaking loose and running wild. Till recently I reined them in behind a casual front. I'm older now and wiser, not so quick to fall in love. Then why did I waken this morning with a song inside my head? And why the smile upon my lips, the lift in every step? And why when I walked among summer wildflowers of widest range of hue, were all the colors brightened by the memory of you?
long time, and though I'm scared of letting down the barriers inside, already you have touched my heart to melt away the ice. And so I woke this morning with a song inside my head, and with a smile upon my lips, I left an every step. And then when I walked among summer wildflowers of widest range of hue, the colors of rue brighter with the memory of you. And so I woke this morning with a song inside my head, and with a smile upon my lips, I lived in every step. And now when I walk among summer wildflowers of widest range of hue, the colors all grow brighter with the memory of you.
Thank you very much. Enjoy the day. Thank you. I'm not going very far. I will do another one for you.
I can do one of those. At the same time. Now that would be a trick.
I could do it, except they're in different tunings. Actually, they told me I have time for a couple more, so I'm going to do two together that fit together. First one's called Hibernation, and the second one is one that somebody asked for, so I'll just kind of use that excuse to do this first one, too. Let's see, piano a cappella.
Let's do it here.
Piano? You think so? How about a little electric piano on this one? What do you think?
Scarce can feel.